Hello guys, so in this video we are going to see fundamental concepts about JDBC or the basic introduction part for JDBC. First of all, what is JDBC? JDBC is a database connectivity, means that it is the process of interacting with the database from Java application. JDBC is the process of interacting with the database from Java application. This is called as which one? JDBC. So before going to interact with the database from Java application, first we have to understand what is database, what is database management system, how many types of database management systems are existed, all these fundamentals we have to understand. After that, we will think about it, how to interact with the database from Java application. Clear. If you go for any enterprise application development, or else if you want to prepare any software application for an enterprise, in that software application we have to manage the details about our organizations or enterprises. Which details here we are going to manage? Maybe about the organization we have to provide some details. Inside the organizations, number of employees are existed. We have to provide employees details. For this organization, number of customers are registered. We have to manage this customers details. From the organizations, number of services are available. That services details we have to provide. From the organization, we are able to have a number of products. That products details we have to manage. And so on, and so on, and so on. Details about our organization we have to manage in our software system, software product, that means software. To manage all these details in our software application, we have to go for storage areas. We need to use which one? Storage areas. What is the storage area? Storage area is a memory element to store all these details. About the organization, which data is available, all these details we have to manage in the storage areas. Maybe employee details, maybe customers details, maybe clients details, maybe products details, maybe services details, and so on and so on and so on. All these things we have to manage in our enterprise application. For that purpose, we have to go for which one? Storage areas. That's clear. Good. How many types of storage areas are existed in our enterprise applications in general? In general, there are two types of storage areas here we are having there. What are the two types of storage areas here? Storage areas, there are two types of storage areas are existed here in outside. What are the two types of storage areas are existed here? Temporary storage areas, and second one is which one? Permanent storage areas. Right, sir. This is temporary storage areas, first one. Temporary storage areas. And second one is which one? Permanent storage areas. Good. The second one is which one? Permanent storage areas. Okay, fine. Temporary storage areas are able to manage the data up to some temporary time or temporary purpose only. They are not storing data permanently. What are the examples for this temporary storage areas now? In general, we are going to use buffers and Java objects for temporary storage areas. Temporary storage areas are able to store data up to some temporary purpose only, not permanently. So examples are which one? Buffers and Java objects. Buffers is very common temporary storage area. Everywhere we are going to use it. But Java objects, how Java objects are temporary storage areas? How can we say Java objects are temporary storage areas? It's very clear. In general, in Java applications, we are going to store data in the form of objects only. But how long these objects are going to be stored? How much time that objects are going to be managed? How long these objects are going to be stored? If you observe this point here, Java objects are able to store data. Java objects are existed in Java applications. How long the Java application is running? How much time the Java application is running? Up to the time maybe the Java objects are available. Means that if you store any data inside the Java object, that the data is available how long the Java program is running, max. Maybe in some situations, in the middle of the program, Java object is not having a reference. If the reference is terminated for any Java object, automatically that object is eligible for garbage collection. When object is eligible for garbage collection, when object is destroyed by garbage collector, automatically our data is going to be removed. Our data is going to be destroyed. So data is not permanent now. Data is temporary only. Why? Because Java object is temporary. So once Java object is temporary, our data is also be temporary. So here Java objects are acting as which one? Temporary storage areas only, not permanent storage areas. That's fine. Next one, if you come for this permanent storage areas, permanent storage areas are able to store data permanently. Permanently. That means if you destroy the data, then only the data is going to be disturbed. If you are not destroying the data is going to be available permanent in our system. Good. So this is the meaning of which one? Permanent storage areas. Tell me, what are the various permanent storage areas in general? In general, there are three types of permanent storage areas we are able to identify. What are the three types of permanent storage areas in general and outside there? First one is file systems, and second one is database management systems, and the third one is data warehouses. First one is file systems, second one is database management systems, third one is data warehouses. Good. Now here we are having a question. Already we have file systems to manage the data permanently, then what is the requirement to go for database management systems? Already we have database management systems to store data permanently, then what is the requirement to go for data warehouses? Clear. If you observe these points, no? If you come for the differences between file system and database management systems, or for the question, what is the need to go for database management systems over file systems, if you come for this point, number of drawbacks are available with the file systems. What are the various drawbacks with this file system? File system is a system provided by the local operating system. File system is not secondary memory device. File system is a system provided by the local operating system. Means that file system is dependent on the operating system. File system is which one can know? Dependent on the operating system. Means that file system is which one can know? Platform dependent. File system is platform dependent. Once the file system is platform dependent, so it is not suitable for the platform independent programming languages like Java or .NET or any other. Why? Because file system is which one they know? Platform dependent. So it is not suitable for platform independent programming languages. If we use file system as a backend for our platform independent programming languages, automatically this platform independent programming languages are able to lose their platform independence in nature. So because of this reason, file systems are not suitable for platform independent programming languages. This is one point. Next one, another reason is which one? How much data these file systems are able to store? Do you think about it? These file systems are storing that more and more data, huge and huge volumes of data? No. File systems are able to store lesser data. File systems are able to store max less data, very less data only that file systems are able to store. File systems are not storing more data. Clear. How much security that file systems are able to provide? Do you think about it? Very good security is provided by these file systems, no? Max file systems are providing security level up to username and password kind of security only. More than that, security is not provided by file systems. Means that file systems are providing lesser security. File systems are not providing more security for our data, they are providing lesser security. Clear? Next one. File systems are able to increase data redundancy. Duplicate data will be increased. Let's say for example, if you go for any university, or if you, any student wants to take admission in that university there, already is a seat is allocated in that respective university, he may go to the university. Then in that university, first he'll go to the administrative block where he has to be reported. If that university is using file system, for example, first administrative block people have to take the respective student details. One copy they will be maintained on their system. When the formalities are completed at administrative block, the same student has to go for which one? Academic block. In the academic block, again, he has to be reported. In academic block, again, might be the respective representative will take the same student details again. Second time, the same student details has to be managed. Okay, fine. Academic block formalities are completed. Then he may go for which one? Computer science department. He might be taking seat in computer science. He has to go for computer science department, where again, the same student has to give his information to the computer science department representative, where the representative will take that student details again. Next one. He wants to go for which one? Library. He wants to utilize some library facility in the university. Again, he will go to the library. In the library, in charge may be existed. So, the same student has to give his information to which one? Librarian. Library in charge. Again, that library in charge will maintain the same student fourth time. Next one. He wants to appear for the exams there. So, he has to go for, he has to apply for the exams. Again, he has to go for examination branch cell. There he has to give the same information, same student has details has to be given once again. That examination branch in charge has to take the same student details now. Again, fifth time the same student details are going to be managed. See, understand it? That university is a single university. If that university is using file system there, single student details are maintained almost all 5 to 6 times again. No? So this is nothing but which one? Data duplication. This data duplication is also be called as which one there? Data redundancy. So file system is able to increase which one care no? Data redundancy. It able to increase data redundancy. So data redundancy is not at all good, not at all suitable in our content. So this is another reason why file system is not suitable for our applications. Next, one more thing. Good. Do you have any query language support for the file system? For example, I have student.txt file, I have there. Student.txt I have there, where might be some students' data is available, 10 students' data is available. Can I write select a star from student.txt to get data from that respective text file? Is it possible to get the total data just by using select a star from student.txt file? No. So the problem is which one? The point is which one? File system is not providing query languages support. No query languages support. No query language support is existed. If query language support is available, it's okay. Then our database operations are somewhat simple. But here query language support is not existed. So when query language support is not available, automatically database operations are very much complex. They are not much easy. So these are the various problems we are able to identify in general with the file system. To overcome these problems, we have to go for which one can know? Database management system. To overcome these problems here, we have to go for which one? Database management systems. Understand it once again. There are two types of storage areas, temporary storage areas and permanent storage areas. These permanent storage areas are available in three things. File systems, database management systems and data warehouses. Now our question is, already we have file system, then what is the requirement to go for database management system? Good. Means that already we have some drawbacks with this file system. To overcome these drawbacks only, we have to go for which one? Database management system. With the file system, majorly we identified these 5 number of drawbacks. What are these drawbacks here? File system is a platform dependent, so it is not suitable for our platform independent programming languages like Java and so on. File system is able to store less data, file system is able to provide less security, and file system is able to increase data redundancy, that means duplication of the data will be increased. Next one, file system is not having any query languages support, so database operations are very much complex. So because of these reasons might be, we have to go for database management system. Database management system is very good when compared with this file system. Why? Because it is not platform dependent. Database management system is not platform dependent. It is independent of the operating systems. Database management system is able to manage large and large data, huge volumes of data. No problem. More data it able to manage. And it able to provide very good security for our data, database management systems. And next one is, database management systems are able to reduce and data redundancy. Might be number of normal forms are available. 1NF, 2NF, 3NF and 4NF, 5NF, like this number of normal forms are available. Not only these normal forms, it is having its own features to reduce data redundancy, to improve data reusability. So database management system is having a number of alternatives to improve data reusability. Moreover, database management systems are having query languages support. Because of this query languages support only, database operations are becoming as very simple. In the case of which one? Database management system. So, database management system is very good when compared with which one? File systems. But again, here we are having a question. What is my question now? Already we have database management system, then what is the requirement to go for data warehouses? Already we have database management system, then what is the requirement to go for data warehouses? Understand this clearly, you know. Again, the problem is which one? With the database management systems, again we are having some problems. Because of these problems only, we have to go for which one? Data warehouses. What are the problems with these database management systems? Majorly two problems are available. When compared with the file systems, database management systems are able to store more data, agree. But when compared with the data warehouses, it able to store less data only. Instead of saying less data, just we can understand middle level data, middle volumes of the data, average. So very low data will be managed by file systems, but somewhat more data managed by which one? Database management systems. Clear cut information. Database management systems are able to store more data when compared with the file system. But when compared with the data warehouses, it is able to store less data. That is one point. Next one is which one? Database management systems are very good while inserting data, while updating data, while deleting data, while performing these operations, database management systems is very good. That's fine. But database management systems are not good while retrieving data from databases. If it is 5 records or 10 records of data from database you want to retrieve, it's okay, no problem. We are able to see somewhat better performance. But if you want to retrieve hundreds of records from databases, and a few hundreds of records if you want to retrieve from databases there, definitely it may take lot of time. Much more time it able to take. So database management system is very good while performing insert, update, to delete this type of operations, but database operations are not good at the time of retrieving the data. Why? Because why it is not good at the time of retrieving the data? No fast retrieval mechanisms. No fast retrieval mechanisms. Retrieval mechanisms are not good in the case of database management systems. They are not at all fast. They are slower mechanisms. Performance will be down while performing retrieval operations. Because of these two reasons might be, we have to go for data warehouses. Good, it's okay. What exactly the points about these data warehouses here? What we are able to understand about these data warehouses if you observe there. So data warehouses is very good when compared with which one can know file system and as well as with which one can know database management systems. What are the advantages with this data warehouses can know? If you observe this point, data warehouses is able to store more and more data, huge volumes of data, huge data it able to manage there. It's okay. Good. And another thing is which one there? It is having fast retrieval mechanisms. It is having fast retrieval mechanisms in the form of data mining techniques. Data warehouses are having fast retrieval mechanisms in the form of data mining techniques. But this kind of mechanisms are not available with the database management systems and with the file systems here. So because of these two reasons, we have to go for which one? Data warehouses. These are the differences between file system, database management system and data warehouses here. We are able to understand clearly. Now, good. Three types of systems here we identified clearly. But here my question is, tell me where we are going to use file systems, where we are going to use database management systems and where we are going to use data warehouses. This is my requirement. So answers are very clear. For example, I have a product. Inside this product, number of items are going to be entered. I'm giving information about where I'm going to use file system. I have a product now. Inside my product, number of items are going to be added to the list. If any item is added to the list, immediately I want to manage a message in a file. Which message there? This item is added. That log I want to get. That information, that notification I want to get, that notified information I want to manage in the form of a file. Whenever I am deleting an item from the list, I want to get a notice. That message I want to store. And whenever that item is updated, I want to get a notice. That item, I want to manage that message. So in my product, whenever item is added, a message will be triggered, generated. That message I want to manage. Whenever an item is updated, I want to get a message and I want to manage this message. Whenever an item is deleted, there also I want to get a message. That message I want to manage. To manage such kind of messages, we have to go for which one? File system only. If you go for number of servers in outside, maybe Apache Tomcat or maybe which one there, any web applications we are using, for example, any web application or any enterprise application, if you use there, for example, then logs we are going to be generated. Logs are going to be generated, which are going to manage the statuses of the servers information or maybe entities, whatever the events we are performing there, their statuses we are going to manage inside our log files. So there also we are going to use file system to manage these log messages clearly. So like this, a number of situations are available. Where huge data is not going to be stored, where the small data we want to be stored on a single file system, in a single system, there we are going to use which one? File system. Next one, where we are going to use database management system. For example, if you want to store students' details of a particular organization, Durga sort for example. If you want to store student details about our Durga soft, there we are unable to use file system. There we have to use which one there? No, database management systems only. Let's say for example, a number of situations are available in outside here. If you want to manage the details, for example, if you want to go for any shop, a small scale shop, small scale organization, if you go there, where if you want to manage products details, items details, if you want to manage there, there we are going to use which one? Database management systems. Good. But I have a requirement. I want to manage which one? A particular bank information. Bank details I want to manage. Bank customers details I want to manage. If we take HDFC bank, for example, I want to manage all the customers details of the HDFC bank. How many number of customers are available for HDFC bank? No? Let's say for example, ICICI bank I am going to take. How many number of customers are available at a time for my ICICI bank? No? So there might be billions of customers are available. But all these billions of customers details I have to manage. So my file system is not sufficient. Database management system is not sufficient. Where there definitely we must go for which one there? Data warehouses. So depending on the situation, we are going to select the required system. File system is for small data, just like logs information about our products. Database management system about which one there? 1,000 members details or maybe 1,000 employee details or 2,000 employee details, okay, we are able to manage it. And if you want to go for huge and huge volumes of the data, a bank information if you want to provide there, then definitely we have to go for which one? Data warehouses. That's it. This is what exactly the differences between file system, database management systems and data warehouses can clear. Good. Now here I have a question now. What about my question here clearly? My question is, here we are understanding about database management system. Here my question is, what is the difference between database and database management system? What is the difference between database and database management system? This is my question. This is a very simple answer for this question. Try to recognize this. First here we have to understand one level definitions for this. Database is a storage area. Database is a storage area. It is able to store data. It is able to store data. Simply speaking, database is a memory element. Database is a memory element or storage area. Our storage area or memory element, it able to store data, that's it. This is the meaning of database. But what about this database management system? Database management system is a software system. Database management system is a software system. Database management system is a software system. It able to manage the data by storing it in databases and by retrieving it from databases. Database is a system, is a database management system, is a software system. It able to manage the data by storing it in databases and by retrieving it from databases. This is one level definition here we have to understand for database and database management system. But another context is available, another definition is available for database. What exactly the other definition for this database? No, database is the collection of interrelated data. Database is a collection of interrelated data. Good. If you understand, for example, Durgasoft is an organization. Durgasoft is an organization where I am going to discuss about, where I am going to give clarity on interrelated data. What is the meaning of interrelated data? I am giving clarity on it. Durgasoft is an organization. Students are coming for Durgasoft. Students are coming to Durgasoft for the sake of courses. Here student, Durgasoft. Students are coming to the Durgasoft. Student and Durgasoft, two entities, no? Relationship is available. They are coming for which one? Courses. Course is another entity. Student, Durgasoft, course. Students are coming for Durgasoft for the courses teached by the faculty members. So here student, Durgasoft, courses and faculty, related data. Students are coming to the Durgasoft for courses teached by the faculty at the respective schedules. So again here what we are having there is student and Durgasoft, faculty, courses, schedules. If you observe all these entities, you know, related data here we are having. So this total collection, this total collection of related data is called as which one can know? Database. Database is the collection of interrelated data. But what is the meaning of this database management system? What exactly the meaning of database management system can know? Answer is very clear. Understand it. Database management system is the collection of database management system is the collection of interrelated data and a set of programs to access data. And a set of programs to access data. Database management system is a collection of interrelated data and a set of programs to access data. Good. That means that what I am telling, the database management system is a database and a set of programs to access data. Database in the sense is the collection of interrelated data. And set of programs. What is the meaning of the set of programs? These set of programs are used to store data, retrieve data, update data, delete the data. To perform these operations, we are going to use some set of programs to access the data. Here, accessing the data in the sense, don't think about it, only retrieving the data. Accessing data in the sense, maybe inserting data, updating data, deleting data, and retrieving data. All these things are come under which one? Accessibility of the data. So finally, these are the two small differences between database and a database management system. Observe this clearly. First of all, what is the first definition here? Database is a storage area or memory element. It able to store data. That's it. Database management system is a software system. It able to manage the data by storing it in databases and by retrieving it from databases. Good. Next one is second level definition is which one? Database is a collection of interrelated data. And database management system is the collection of interrelated data and a set of programs to access the data. That's it. This is what exactly the difference between database and a database management systems. It's okay. Now this point is okay, clear. Next, coming to the types of database management systems. N number of database management systems are existed in outside care. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about all these database management systems, but examples wise I want to take only three types of database management systems I want to take. But actually N number of types are available. We are not going to have requirement of all these types, no, just our required things only I'm going to provide. First one is relational database management system, the very first one. Next one is object-oriented database management system. Object-oriented database management system. And third one is which one? Object relational database management systems. Overall, three types of, that means like N number of types are existed here, but at present I am representing only three types here. So overall, three types of object-oriented, three types of database management systems are available. First one is relational database management systems, object-oriented database management systems, and object relational database management systems. In the case of this relational database management systems, data will be represented in the form of tables only. Table in the sense relation, that's it. In relational database management system, data will be stored in the form of tables only. Good. Once the data is stored in the form of tables, and where if you want to perform some manipulations with our data, if you want to perform some database operations with our data existing in our tables, there we have to use a separate query language. That query language is which one? SQL2. SQL in the sense structured query language. The two in the sense it was introduced in 1992. That's it. Structured query language, it was introduced in 1992. Next one. Object-oriented database management systems. Object-oriented database management systems are able to allow the data to represent in the form of objects only. Not in the form of tables. The data will be represented in the form of objects only. Good. If you want to perform operations with the data exists in the form of objects, there we are going to use a separate query language. That query language is which one here? OQL. Here OQL in the sense object query language. Object query language. Object query language in the sense just only object orientation, object oriented features are available. As for these object oriented features only, the data is going to be represented. Like which one here? Abstraction and encapsulation and inheritance and polymorphism. This kind of things are going to be existed. Good, sir. Next one. If you go for object relational database management systems, it able to allow the data in the form of tables as well as in the form of which one? There no objects. Data will be represented in the form of tables and as well as in the form of which one? Objects. Good. But if you want to perform database operations with all these data exists in the form of tables and objects, no, if you want to perform operations for this, there we have to use a separate query language. That separate language is SQL3. This SQL3 is nothing but which one? The combination of SQL2 and plus OQL. It is a combination of SQL2 and OQL. SQL3 is a combination of SQL2 and OQL. That means structured query language with object oriented features. Structured query language with object-oriented features, that is called as which one? SQL3. Understand it clearly, no? Right, so now these are the total, the types of which one, you know, database management systems. Overall, I've given clear-cut information about our storage areas, no? In enterprise applications, if you want to manage the data, like employees' details, customers' details, clients' details, products' details, and so on, and so on, and so on, we need to go for storage areas. There are two types of storage areas in general. Temporary storage areas and permanent storage areas. Temporary storage areas are able to store data temporarily only, but permanent storage areas are able to store data permanently. In general, two examples are available for temporary storage areas. Buffers, they are the very common thing to use the temporary storage, and Java object. Java objects are temporary storage areas. Why? Because Java objects are for temporary purpose only, not for permanently. They will not be stored in our system permanently. Up to how long our Java program is running, up to that only objects are going to be available. Good. There are three types of permanent storage areas now. File systems, database management systems, and data warehouses. Already we have file systems, then what is the requirement to go for database management system? File systems are having some problems. What are the problems here? It is platform dependent, which is provided by local operating system. It able to store less data. It able to provide less security. It able to increase data redundancy. No query language support is available for this. Database operations are very much complex. To overcome these problems, we have to go for which one? Database management systems. In a database management systems, then database management system is not platform dependent. It able to store more data, it able to provide more security, and it able to reduce data redundancy, and it able to improve data reusability. Query language support is available, database operations are very simple. But still some problems are available with the database management system. Problems are, when compared with the file system, it able to store more data. But when compared with the data warehouses, it able to store less data. Next one is, and no fast travel mechanisms are available for database management systems. While inserting data, while updating data, while deleting data, database management system is good. But while retrieving data, database management system is not good. So we have to go for data warehouses. Data warehouses are able to store more and more data. Huge volumes of data it able to store. Next one is which one? It is having fast retrieval mechanisms in the form of data mining techniques. Because of these reasons only, we have to go for this data warehouses now. But when we are going to use file system, whenever we want to manage small data, that means logs information in our web application, logs information in our server side, server information, there we are going to use which one? File system. If you want to store details about our Durga soft, might be, we are going to use which one? Database management system. But if you want to manage any particular bank account details there, we have to go for data warehouses. How many types of database management systems are available? Number of database management systems are available, but where three of them I explained clearly. First one is relational database management system. It able to store data in the form of tables only, and to manipulate the data or to perform operations with our data which is exist in the form of tables, there we have to use SQL2 as a query language, structured query language 2 that we have to use. In object-oriented database management system, data will be represented in the form of objects only. To perform operations with these objects, we need to go for which one there? OQL, object query language. Next one is, in object relational database management system, data will be represented in the form of tables and objects only. So if you want to perform database operations with the data exist in the form of objects and tables, there we have to go for a separate query language. That query language is SQL3, where SQL3 is a combination of SQL2 and OQL. So this is overall awareness about which one they know, storage areas. So before moving for JDBC, we need to understand the storage areas clearly. Once you understood clearly the storage areas, then we will think about it, how to interact with the storage areas, that means databases from our Java applications. In the middle, I've given one interview question there, what exactly the difference between database and database management system. Here we have answers clearly, Database is a storage area or memory element, it able to store data. Database management system is a software system, it able to manage the data by storing it in databases and by retrieving it from databases. Next, another context I have given, another level definition I have given. Database is a collection of interrelated data. Database management system is a collection of interrelated data and a set of programs to access data. Here, set of programs are for inserting the data, updating the data, and deleting data clearly. So, this is overall awareness on which one there. Database and database management systems and storage areas clearly. Good.